TikTok supplies for these cute little ornaments. And I am going to show you two options of granny hexagons to use for this. One's a puff stitch, one's a traditional style of granny hexagon. And they're both so cute. And you can choose how you want to do your colors for each of these and mix it up. I have a color inspiration guide within the paid pattern that is fun to use to decide what you're going to use for your colors. Now for this pattern, I used Wren, and this is the one I'm going to be showing here, but you can do whatever colors you want. But use Wren as my main color. This is the white color. And then I also use Mink and Wasabi for the one you see here. This is the traditional granny hexagon. And this is what I'm going to be showing a little bit today. But I'll also show you in the Wren how to do the puff stitch one as well. Now you will need a bauble for this. This is one of those squished ones, I guess you could say. It's a little bit oval on one side. I love these. They come in two different sizes. So there's a small one and a large one. I'm going to show you how to do the large one, which is 4 rounds. But for the smaller one, you just simply do 3 rounds and it works out great. You will also want the size G 4mm hook, scissors, a yarn needle. And then if you want, we can put some beads on here just to dress it up and make it a little bit fun. So I have some twine string and some beads, and I'll show you how to do that as well. I just find them to be kind of a romantic look for the holidays. So let's go ahead and get started making these really cute ornaments. We're going to start today by showing you how to make the traditional granny hexagon, and we'll do the puff one next. But we're going to create a magic ring or a magic circle and then chain one. And in this magic ring, we will be doing first a stacked single crochet, and that's when we yarn over and pull up a loop and yarn over and pull through two, and then we're going back into that left bar, yarning over and pulling up one, yarning over and pulling through two. I have a full tutorial about this on my blog, but it is smart to mark that first stitch if you've never worked this before, because it can be difficult to see where the first stitch of the round is. This blends in nicely. And now we're going to do another double crochet and then chain one. And then we will do two double crochets into this magic ring and chain one. We're going to be doing that for a total of 5 times, which means at the end we will have 12 stitches and 6 chains. So we're just doing groupings of double crocheting two and chaining one all the way around. And now after working all of those stitches, we can go ahead and close that magic ring by pulling our tail end, and then we'll be ready for round two. Now for round two, we will be slip stitching into that very first stitch of the previous round, so that stacked single crochet, and then we will slip stitch into the next stitch as well. So we're working over until we get to that chain one space from the previous round. Now, if you are switching colors here, go ahead and fasten off your yarn. I've only done one slip stitch so far. And so for our next slip stitch, we are going to go ahead and grab the next color for this round and pull it through for that second slip stitch starting off this round. And now we're ready and set up with our new color to work into that chain one space from the previous round. We're going to insert our hook into that chain one space and work a stacked single crochet. But if you want to make things easier, you can work over your tail ends if you don't want to weave them in later. I don't recommend this for garments, but I'm totally fine working over my ends for something like this. So I'm going to start with a stacked single crochet and then a double crochet one into the same space, and then a chain one. And now we're going to double crochet 2 more stitches into that chain space. And then we are going to chain one. Now we're going to do this repeat in the chain spaces all the way around, but the repeat will be to do 2 double crochets, chain one, and 2 double crochets into each chain space around. And you can see I'm still working over those tail ends. I just don't want to weave them later, but you can give them a tug here and there to make sure that the tension is okay, but you don't want to pull them too tight. So repeat around by doing 2 double crochets, chain one, 2 double crochets, then chain one, and we'll do that in each chain space around. Now for round three, we're going to slip stitch to the first chain one space from the round below, but I'm also going to be changing colors. So I'm going to slip stitch one in the Wren, and I'm going to leave this color attached because I'll be using it again. But now I'm going to go ahead and grab the Wasabi color that I want to use, and I'm going to slip stitch my second slip stitch of this round with the Wasabi. And then we will be at that chain one space of the previous round and ready to get started. So working in that chain one space, we are going to do what we did kind of from the round below. We're going to start with a stacked single crochet. And then if you want to work over those tail ends, you can go ahead and work over the Wasabi, but the Wren is going to stay attached. We're going to use it again. So we don't need to work over it. We don't need to cut it off, at least for this coloring, but you can mix it up as much as you want. So now we'll be doing another double crochet stitch in that chain one space. And then chain one and two double crochet into that same space again. And now we're going to chain one. And in the next chain one space, we're going to do two double crochet stitches. And then we are going to chain one. So this will be our repeat. Now we're going to do two double crochet stitches, chain one, two double crochet stitches, all into the next chain one space. And I'm still working over my tail end here. And then chain one. And now we're going to do two double crochet stitches in the next chain one space. And then chain one. And we'll be repeating that all the way around until we get to back to the beginning of this round. Now, if you are using the smaller bauble ornament inside of here, you can stop after round three. You can do round four for the bigger one, but if you're making that small one, go ahead and fasten off. But we're gonna keep going for round four. Now for round four, I'm going to switch back to the Wren color. But first I'm going to slip stitch one stitch in this color. And then for the next slip stitch, I'm simply going to bring the Wren up from the backside up a row. And then it's fine if it just sits on the back. You just don't want to pull this too tight. And now I'm back to the Wren color and we're ready to work in that chain one space. And I will be working around the Wasabi color, but I'm going to fasten it off first to make this a little bit easier. And now we're going to start this chain one space by doing what we've been doing before. We're going to start with a stacked single crochet and then another double crochet in that chain one space and then chain one and then two more double crochets in that chain one space. And then we will chain one. And in the next chain one space, we will do two double crochets. Chain one, and in the next chain one space, we'll do two double crochets. And chain one. And this is going to be our repeat around. So in the next chain one space, we're going to start this repeat with doing two double crochets. And then chain one and two double crochets into that same chain one space. Like to pull that tail end every once in a while to make sure it's sitting nicely if you're working over it. And then chain one. And then in the next chain one space, we will work two double crochet stitches. And chain one. And then do that again. In the next chain one, work two double crochet stitches. And chain one. And that's our repeat to work all the way around. Now for this first ornament hexagon, we can go ahead and fasten off and do an invisible join, which I've already done for this one here. But for your second one, as you can see, I'm leaving my yarn attached. This is what it looks like when it's done and fastened off. But we'll want to go ahead and leave our yarn attached on the second one we make so that we can join them for the ornament. Next, we're going to go over how to make this puff stitch hexagon. And this is the other option you have for this pattern. We're going to start with a magic circle for this hexagon as well. And we will start by using a stacked single crochet, kind of like how we did before on the previous one. And how we do that once again is insert our hook into the circle, yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through two, and then go back through that horizontal bar on the left side, yarn over and pull up a loop, and yarn over and pull through two. And now we are going to mark that stitch if we need to, so we know the beginning of this round. And next we will be double crocheting 11 more double crochets into this ring for a total of 12 stitches, including that stacked single crochet. And now that we have all the stitches worked into that magic ring, we can go ahead and pull that closed tightly, and we're ready to start working some of these awesome puff stitches. So we're not going to join, we're simply going to insert our hook into the first stitch, and we're going to start by doing a modified puff stacked single. So we're going to pull up a loop and yarn over and pull through two, and then we're going to go back through that left bar and pull up a loop, but we're going to stop right here, and we're going to go ahead and work some of those puffs style stitches. So we're going to yarn over and insert into the same stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, and do that again. Yarn over and insert into the same stitch, and yarn over and pull up a loop. And then I like to pull through all the loops except for the last one, and then I yarn over and pull through two. I feel like that just makes a really nice looking puff stitch. So now we're going to chain one, and then we're going to do that again. So now we're going to do a puff stitch this time where we yarn over and pull up a loop three times, and then we yarn over and pull through six, and then yarn over and pull through two, and then chain one. So one more time, we're going to yarn over and insert into the next stitch, pull up a loop, do that two more times until you have a total of seven loops on your hook. And then you will yarn over and pull through the first six. And then we will yarn over and pull through the last two and chain one. The chain one will happen after every puff stitch in this round. Now we're just going to keep doing that all the way around. So you'll have a total of 12 puff stitches and 12 chain one spaces. And we'll keep doing that until we get to the end of this round. Now that we are at the end of the round, it might pull in a little bit, but it'll flatten out. We're going to go ahead and slip stitch into the first stitch of the round. And now we're ready to work into that first chain one space. So we're going to insert our hook into the chain one space, and we're going to start by creating that stacked puff stitch where it's a modified stacked single crochet. We're kind of turning it into a puff stitch. And after creating the stacked puff stitch, we will chain one. And then we're going to do another puff stitch into that same chain one space. Now in the next chain one space, we're going to be doing a puff stitch, a chain one, and a puff stitch all into that chain one space. And this is what will be our repeat all the way around. So at the end of this round, we will have 24 puff stitches and 12 chain stitches. So we'll keep doing that all the way around where we do a puff stitch, a chain one, and a puff stitch into each chain one space around. Now you're really going to find this might curl in a bit at this point, but this next round is what will really even it out. But once again, if you're doing a smaller ornament, you're going to stop here at round three. Now to finish out round three, we are going to slip stitch to that modified puff stack single crochet to join. And now we're ready to start round four. And in that first chain one space, we're going to do a stacked single crochet. And then we're going to do two more double crochets and then chain one and three double crochets into that chain one space. We're placing a lot of stitches into that chain one space. And in the next chain one space, we are going to double crochet three. And in the next chain one space, we are going to do a three double crochet, chain one, three double crochet. And this is going to be our repeat around. So in the next chain one space, we will double crochet 3 stitches. And then in the next chain one space, we will do 3 double crochet, chain one, 3 double crochet. And then finish that off with doing the 3 double crochets in the last chain one space of the round. So I'll come back when we get to that last chain one space. Now we are finishing this round by working 3 double crochets into that last chain one space. And now we are ready to fasten off and do a join. Now I just want to show you how to do an invisible join with this. And this is where you're going to want to grab your yarn needle. Now this is one of my favorite joins. We're going to look at this second stitch in this round. So not the first, but the second. And we're going to insert our needle through that as if we were going to crochet it and pull it all the way through. And then we're going to go back down the last stitch worked. So we're not adding or decreasing any stitches here. We're working over that first stitch, making this mock stitch that you'll see happen on the top. And now the stitch count is correct. And we've joined with a very invisible join. Now for the ornament, you will only do this for the first one. For the second hexagon, we won't want to fasten off. Now, since we have 2 of these and we didn't fasten off the second one, we're going to go ahead and talk about how to join these together while also sticking the ornament inside here and finishing it off. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to take this first one, grab our crochet hook, and we're simply going to slip stitch to join. But we're doing a little bit more than that just to make it easy. We're actually going to be slip stitching to the very first chain one space of this round. And that way it's a little bit easier to work around the ornament and have the top of the ornament kind of be at one of the points of the hexagon. So I'm going to slip stitch the first 5 stitches, including that chain space, until we get to the point where we are now at the chain one space of this round after slip stitching 5. So now we're ready to grab our other hexagon once we have slip stitched to this chain one space after slip stitching 5. And I'm going to insert my hook through the back loop only of this chain one space. And then I'm going to find that chain one space on the opposite hexagon that's the exact same one that matches up. So there's the chain one. We're matching up point to point on these hexagons. And I'm inserting my hook from top to bottom. And then we're going to yarn over from underneath and we're going to slip stitch all of these loops on the hook together. It can be a little bit tricky the first time you do this, but the key is to rotate your hook a lot. Like let your hook rotate in your fingers and rotate your wrist, and that makes it a little bit easier. And now I'm going to slip stitch on this side in the front loop and then the back loop of the current side and then join those together. So I'm only working through front and back loops on this one. I like that look of the stitching, and whichever side I started on last time, I tend to do that start on the opposite side the next time. And that way it's just a really nice flat slip stitch all the way around. Now we're just going to want to keep working that way all the way around until we have an opening where the ornament can still easily slide in. So we don't want to go back to where we started because we want to be able to get this ornament in here. So I usually do at least 4 sides and then I come back and put that ornament in there. Now that we've slip stitched almost all the way around, we're going to go ahead and grab that ornament to go inside of there and push it in. And then we're going to rotate the top of it to be where we started. So those 5 stitches on the front that we slip stitched across, that's where we want to rotate the top of it. And now we're simply going to continue to work the way we have been and close it. Now pulling the sides of this together with your left hand. So I'm kind of squishing these sides together with my left hand. And then I'm looping through the same way as I did before with my right hand. Then I'm just going to keep doing the same slip stitches together until I get as close to that bauble as I can in those first 5 slip stitches of this round. And I just have to keep kind of squishing it together so that I can easily work through those stitches to join them. Now I'm on the last stitches of this round. I can go ahead and fasten off. If this gets a little bit difficult, you can always just seam it with a yarn needle. That's totally fine as well, whatever's most comfortable for you. And now I'll simply weave in this end, and then we'll talk about putting a little bit of extra on here with some beads. Now to put some beads on here, I'm first gonna cut a piece of twine. I tend to cut it longer than I probably need it, but I always like to have extra just so I don't run out and it's easy. And then I'm gonna fold it in half, and I'm going to pinch it through the top of the ornament. And we're gonna do what's called a lark's head knot. And that's where we're going to go ahead and take the other two ends and put it through that loop we just made, and then pull it tight. Now the next step is to string on some beads, and I have different sizes of beads here, and I can usually get them through one strand quite easily, but then I will get out a yarn needle to get the second strand through because it's just too hard to push them through it. The twine tends to fray a bit. So I'm gonna put these on this way and then grab a yarn needle to put the other strand through. And now this is where I've grabbed the needle that's a little bit smaller, and I'm just gonna weave through these so that I get both strands through all of the beads. Now once all the beads are in there, you can simply go ahead and tie a knot on the end so they don't slip off. And then you can cut off any extra twine you have here depending on how long you want that strand to be after the beads. Obviously I did mine way too long, so I'm gonna grab some scissors and cut off some of this, leaving a little bit for a little extra touch. And that is how we add beads to this ornament. Now these are so fun to work up, and you can also do them in the smaller size by just doing three rounds and the same instructions for joining them. They're so cute. They also match the advent calendar and the stocking I did this year. So they're fun to do as a set. I really hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Hit that subscribe button and come back for more fun projects soon.